Yes, back again, dispelling myths out there, while dealing with radical faith and stuff like that there, and alleged occult symbols. Hit that music. Right, it's the warrior, and right now I'm warring against disinformation, deception, and lies spreading around in the Christian community as we're dealing with this topic here. Now, the alleged cross of Nero, which we know as the peace symbol that, you know, most people are familiar with, and again, we've got to be careful and stop just blindly accepting what Googled websites say. Make sure if a website or a book or whatever doesn't have any endnotes, footnotes, references, things like that, be very, very skeptical. I don't care if it's the holiest Christian in the world that you might think of. If the book isn't well documented, you know, be very skeptical. And the next thing I'd like to say, again, I'm trying to encourage you to go beyond, you know, just reading someone's book. When you see the reference, get up, take the book to the library, and find the book, okay? Or you can even do research online, find it online, and then go get that book and check the reference and see what else, what other source is being referenced regarding that. Because invariably what you'll find is that people who aren't credible in what they're saying tend to quote others who aren't credible in what they're saying. And so you have this vicious circular reasoning going on here, you know, like a Jehovah's Witness coming to you, quoting another Jehovah's Witness book, quoting another Jehovah's Witness book, or whatever, okay? The same thing applies when it comes to alleged occult symbols. Now, like I said, I'm going to have links in my more info section for you people to check out, because the real reason, okay, or should I say the real origin of the peace symbol, all right, is not occultic. Now, here's a some information here I have on my laptop. The peace symbol was originally created by a man by the name of, where is his name? Now, I know I had that man's name right down here, and it's disappeared. Can you believe it? The warrior has lost his notes. Well, I have my computer thing right up here, and I can find it very quickly. You just gotta love having access to high speed. Okay, his name was Gerald Holtom, H-O-L-T-O-M. So instead of looking up Cross of Nero, I would look up the peace symbol, or origins of the peace symbol. And here's what it says on one of the websites, the Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament. You see, because Gerald Holtom explains why. In fact, let me read that so you can see it for yourself, because this gets ridiculous, and we've got to be better as Christians. We've got to be better, and we've got to know what we're talking about completely. Now, this is what the man who created the peace symbol in 1958, all right, this is what he said when he made the symbol. I drew myself, a man in despair, put a circle around it to represent the world, planet Earth, with one little man in despair in it. The problem in justifying this symbol was resolved when I began to analyze the origin of the despair gesture. Perhaps such gestures predated alphabets, he says. Obviously, I turned to semaphore signals and found that this gesture stood for N, negative, and that the vertical stood for D, divide. So here I had the justification for the symbol, ND, nuclear disarmament. Okay? And the websites that I'm going to put in my more info section will, you know, you'll be able to see what these signals are and what they mean and how it became to be the peace symbol. But that's just one point I wanted to make. And here's another one that I want to bring up here. As soon as I can bring up the article. Okay. Now, on their website, Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament, here's a quote about the misrepresentation and misuse of the peace symbol. Quote, "There have been claims that the symbol has older occult and anti-Christian associations. In South Africa, under the apartheid regime, there was an official attempt to ban it. Various far-right and fundamentalist American groups have also spread the idea of satanic associations or condemned it as a communist sign. However, the origins and the ideas behind the symbol have been clearly described, both in letters and in interviews, by Gerald Holtom." Okay. "His original first sketches are now on display as part of the Commonwealth Collection in Bradford." Looks like they missed the TH in Commonwealth on that quote. But anyway, so that is the origin of the symbol. Okay, it's not a cross of Nero on one of the Sisters of Mary Mary's dress. It's not. I'm sorry. It's not. And of course, there are other issues. I mean, there's another website that says the John Birch Society, a wild conspiracy society that believes all kinds of wacky stuff, for instance, claimed that it was the Antichrist's broken cross. Now, it's John Birch Society saying this now. I mean, in other words, maybe you want to get some people that believe in, you know, that Bigfoot's hanging around Elvis or something to tell you something about, you know. These aren't credible sources, people. Okay? Purportedly devised by Nero as a nasty way to execute St. Peter. Others claim it was a medieval symbol for the devil and that it bore a striking resemblance to a Nazi badge used during World War II. You know, we've got to stop that. Okay? It's not a cross of Nero. There is no credible, reliable information, documentation, going back to Nero's time, all right, for the peace symbol being a cross of Nero. See? So let's squash that right now. All right. So the next point is, you can also see the whole thing about the cross of Nero issue goes back to this idea that Peter, it's in church tradition, that Peter requested to be crucified upside down, all right, because he didn't feel worthy to be crucified in the same manner as Jesus, which is actually a humble gesture. Now, if that tradition is true, this is where we get the cross of Nero type of stuff, because Nero apparently was the emperor and ruler at the time when Peter was alive and Paul was alive. So that's kind of where we get that from. But again, if the tradition is true, then an upside down cross, I know in popular culture, movies like the Amityville Horror, you know, you have, you know, the cross turning upside down. An upside down cross, if anything, means humility. The humility of Brother Peter, okay, who did not want to be crucified like Jesus, right side up, okay? So an upside down cross is not satanic, it's not an occult symbol. I'm sorry to bust your little bubble, okay? But it's not. So, you know, I know I've gone long on this, but I think it's important enough to deal with this thoroughly, okay? Let's see, what else did I want to point out here? On another website, again, it's going to be up in my more info section, it says, Gary O'Sullivan, then at the University of Pennsylvania, traced the reinterpretation of the upside-down cross in his 1991 essay, The Satanism Scare, okay? According to O'Sullivan, the 1960 book, The Morning of the Magicians, a mystical occult text considered to be the first New Age book, introduced the ideas that the upside-down cross is satanic, and that it was used mockingly by both the Romans and the Nazis. Okay, and this comes from www.commondreams.org. Again, I'm going to put that in my more info section. But you need to check this out and stop. We need to stop this nonsense. We need to do our homework and do it thoroughly and accurately and make sure that these sources are accurate. I'm out of here.